Hi, my name is Robert Veranek. I'm from FEDEVEL Academy, and in this video we are going to learn how to create a custom title block. A title block with the information what you would like to have here. And the title block is going to be filled out mostly automatically. So for example, this page content, this is the page name, and the page name is filled out automatically. Also, date is filled out automatically. Some of these fields are based on project options. So if you go to project options, and when you set some parameters for your project, then here you specify what you will see in the title block. Like you can see project name is LED, or version revision is version 1.1. And then basically, if you need to change this parameter in whole your project, like version revision, you can simply just write it here. And it is automatically updated on all the schematic pages in your whole project. Then in the title block, you can see we have also the variants. So based on the variant which is selected, the name is filled out, and there are few parameters which are specific for the page. For example, if someone checked this specific page, you would like to fill these initials here. So I'm going to select title block, go to parameters of the title block, and just write here initials. Okay, and page number and total pages, they are again automatically updated based on the information which is in tools, annotation, number schematic sheets. So based on this information, is this automatically updated. This custom title block is specified in our schematic symbol library, and it looks like this. Okay, so in this video we are going to create this title block, and I will explain how it works. For this video, I'm going to use one of my previous projects. So if you would like to try it by yourself, just Google for FEDEVEL GitHub let and download the project from here. Download zip. Once you open the project, click into empty space on your schematic page. Go to properties, and down here, page options, uncheck title block. We are going to hide the default title block. Go into libraries, our schematic symbol library, and create new component, which is going to be called title block. Okay, and we are going to draw it. Go to place, line. I'm going to use blue color, this one which is here. And watch down here what grid you are using. We would like to use 100 mils. So go into your canvas, just press right mouse button, hold it down, move the canvas. Now we are in the canvas, and press G on your keyboard, change the grid. 50 mils, 100 mils, okay? Left click, watch down here. We are going to draw a line which is long, like 3500 mils. Okay, somewhere here. And go up here like 1300. Right click. Now press G, change the grid to 50. And draw it maybe like this. Right click. Left, left, right. Left, left, right. Left, left, right. And maybe we can add few more lines. This one, watch down here, I'm going to place it on 600. like this. And I'm going to place one also here, like 2900. And I'm going to place one down here, like 2150, like here. We are going to add some text. Click on place text string. I'm going to use default setting. So left bottom Times New Roman, size 10, and this default blue color. And we need a lot of text. So just place it maybe into similar positions, what I'm going to use. It doesn't have to be exactly same position, but we need a lot of text. Maybe like somewhere here, 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 and this. We are going to adjust the font and color some of the text. So I'm going to select this one, just press left click, press shift, hold it down, select also this one, left click, left click, left, select all these. And in font, we are going to use Arial 7 and this color. We are going to place the text into the right position. So I'm going to select this, press shift, hold it down, select also this. We would like to place it into center of this line, so I'm going to use this option, and the position will be 125. And this one we would like to center, and this one maybe move a little bit like this. Okay, this looks good. Next line, I'm going to select these and place them on 420. Enter. This one I would like to put a little bit up, 670, and this one 920. I just noticed we need one more text, so I'm going to copy this one, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, I will place it here. We are going to center this text, which is here, select, press shift, left click, justification, center on the left, and place it to 625, enter, select this, again, justification, left, center, place it to 875, and also center this text and place it to 1150. We are going to update the text, so just double click and write here date, double click, this is sheet off, and I'm going to copy the rest so it's a little bit faster. Just double click, double click. and only what left are the parameters. There are more places where you can find parameters, what you can use here in the title block. So for example, one place where you can find the parameters is here. Just select the text. And here in this list, you can find some parameters which you can use. So for example, variant name, if you would like to use here. Okay. The next place where you can find parameters is the schematic itself. So I go into schematic, left click into empty space, and then in properties, parameters, you can find all the kind of parameters what you can show in your title block, like sheet total, sheet number, and some other things, okay, about document, current date. All these we can place here, and I'm going to do it right now. So here I'm going to place current date. This one is going to be document name. Sheet number. I'm just copying and pasting these parameters from my text file, but otherwise you would need to go always here, okay, and just copy it or use exactly same name and put it here, okay? And next way or next parameters what you can use here are the project parameters. So we can go here, and if you go into project options, parameters, here you can specify some parameters. And first I'm going to add them into our title block, and then we will specify them for the project. So these are, for example, the parameters like company, project, and revision. And also the table itself can have some parameters because this is symbol, and this symbol can have some parameters. So we are going to add here, for example, parameters like checked by. We would like to make it visible. It is down here. We don't want to do auto position. We would like to move it here, and let's put here default value like this. Then the next parameter what I would like to use is the size, and then in this drawing number. Size dash, make it visible, move it here, and the last one, click on add. Drawing number, make it visible, put it here, oops, and don't forget to disable the auto position. Otherwise, when you place the title block into your schematic, this would move somewhere else into different position. We would like to have it here. Perfect. Only what is missing is this text down here. So just double click, and I'm going to put here designed by URL. Now, something really, really important. You need to set this type to graphical. This means this title block is not going to be transferred to PCB, and it is not going to be visible in BOMs. Okay, so it is just a graphical symbol in your schematic. Very important. Here I'm going to put some description so it looks better here in the library. Maybe something like this. And don't forget to save. Now let's go into schematic and let's have a look what we have created. So once you are in the schematic, don't forget to hide the default title block. Okay, you will do it down here. Press this button and go into our library. So click on components If you cannot see components, use these panels and select components. And then here, select Add Library. And this is the title block what we have created. Right click, place title block. Left click, right click. As you can see, some of the parameters are automatically filled out, like this schematic page name, date and variant. And we are going to add the project parameters for the company, project, design by, URL and the version revision. Click on project, project options, go to parameters, click on add. We would like to add company parameter, so just write company and what we would like to show here. Let's say we would like to show the copyright 2019 FEDEVEL Academy. Okay, so the value is what will be shown here. Click on add project. Let's call it let. Next one is version revision. Version 1 issue 1 and design. Okay. So design by URL. Version revision, project company. Okay. Now watch what is going to happen when I press OK. Perfect. And what we still need to fill out are these numbers and these table parameters. So to update the table parameters, select the table, left click, go to properties, parameters, and let's say we would like to change the size parameter. I'm going to put here A. And after you check the schematic page, you can also, for example, change this parameter. So select table and check by RF. If you would like to update these sheet numbers, you need to go to Tools, Annotation, Number Schematic Sheets. Now, auto sheet number, auto document number, update sheet count. You can see these were automatically filled out and watch what is going to happen here. Perfect. In case you would like to add a new schematic page into your project, right click on the project, add new schematic. Now this is the new schematic page. We would like to hide this default title block and we would like to use our own title block. Go to our schematic symbol library, right click, place our title block. Left click, right click. You can see almost everything is automatically filled out, but we need to update the pages in our project. So go to Tools, Annotation, Number Schematic Sheets. Again, watch what is going to happen here. Auto update sheet count. Okay. Once you press left click into the schematic page, watch what is going to happen. This is going to be updated. Perfect. If you go on our first schematic page, this is automatically updated. Perfect. If you change the variant is going to be automatically updated. And now if we would like to, for example, change the or if we are designing new version of our board, we can simply just go change the parameter here and it will be automatically updated in all title blocks. I'm going to upload this updated project to my GitHub. You will find it here, board, light, YouTube. It will be updated project. There will be the TitleBlock. So if you like, you can download it, you can have a look how I created the TitleBlock, and you can try it by yourself. You can create your own TitleBlock. That's everything for today's video. I would like to know your comments, how you create TitleBlock, so don't forget, leave comments under the video. If you like this video, please press like button. Don't forget to subscribe so you receive notification about new videos what I will create. And I would like to thank you very much for watching and see you next time. Bye.